Wait. Here we go. Ooh, that's weird. I can hear my own voice. Why?
Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment to help me with the algorithm. And why not join the Retoids Digital Dystopia Discord? Link in bio.
Why am I hearing my own voice? Let's just go with it. We'll roll with it. Kids outside are playing. No one wants to watch a dark stream. Like we're watching a film.
April 1973. Tragedy and despair have struck Central Texas. A young college student named Maria Flores has seemingly vanished without a trace. She was last seen near the town of Newt more than 2 weeks ago. But with no physical evidence, the investigation has stalled. With few leads and even less hope, Maria's younger sister, Ana Flores, and a group of her closest friends set out to find their missing loved one. But any grief or sadness caused by Maria's disappearance would pale in comparison to the agony and despair they would soon discover. What awaited this group of youths was a nightmare beyond belief. The events surrounding Maria's disappearance would be just one of the many bizarre crimes later known as the Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Is there anyone? Let's test his microphone.
April 1973. Tragedy and despair have struck Central Texas. A young college student named Maria Flores has seemingly vanished without a trace. She was last seen near the town of Newt more than 2 weeks ago. But with no physical evidence, the investigation has stalled. With few leads and even less hope, Maria's younger sister, Ana Flores, and a group of her closest friends set out to find their missing loved one. But any grief or sadness caused by Maria's disappearance would pale in comparison to the agony and despair they would soon discover. What awaited this group of youths was a nightmare beyond belief. The events surrounding Maria's disappearance would be just one of the many bizarre crimes later known as the Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Just wait for this. I'll test it when my phone's working. Wait, can you still hear me? He's so still. Seems to be a similar sort of layout as Friday the 13th. Yeah, we're gonna be leatherface first.
You're part of the family now. It's up to you to secure the property and stop victims from escaping. The family's way of life depends on it. Keep all doors locked and make sure all exits are closed, trapped, or guarded. Make sure to monitor crucial pieces of equipment like generators, the fuse box, and the water valve pump. The status of these items play a huge role in whether or not victims will have an easy path to escape. Make sure to collect blood from drainage buckets scattered around the map or by attacking victims directly. Feed this newly acquired blood to Grandpa to make him stronger and more effective. The stronger he is, the more powerful his sonar ability will become. Soon he'll be finding and highlighting victims for the whole family to see. Feed Grandpa enough, and he'll give the family new abilities that can be used for the rest of the match. Remember, Grandpa is the best killer that ever was.
Sounds
better. Hunt down the victims using abilities and teamwork. Look for signs of movement and listen for noise. Pay attention to your surroundings and keep your eyes and ears open. You never know where one of those victims might be hiding. Speaking of abilities, each family member has a unique ability that can help.
Yeah, it's just good. Let's just go straight in. I shut head down, can't lose.
You're part of the family.
Don't even know what buttons are for the chainsaw.
Captured by the Slaughter family, tied up, tortured, and left for dead. You must do whatever it takes to escape the family's property at all costs. Find your friends.
Why is everything on ultra? Try that. They're gonna make us wait a minute. It's cigarette time. We're going in.
A series of home invasions throughout Bell County have turned into a search for a known fugitive. Omar Pauly, native of Holland, Texas, was arrested in 1967 for aggravated assault and larceny and was sentenced to 5 years in prison. After his release, Omar Pauly was implicated in a string of incidents outside McLennan County, where he was arrested again but managed to escape authorities. His current whereabouts are unknown. attack on 3 female college students in Pflugerville, Texas last year is back in the public spotlight. Pflugerville citizens are in an uproar demanding answers from Texas state officials on why no arrests have been made in the case. Reports say an unidentified man entered the home in the middle of the night, viciously strangling one female to death before attempting to stab both roommates who were sleeping nearby. Authorities believe the attacker fled the scene after discovering multiple people lived in the house. The man is believed to be in his late 20s, has dark hair and brown eyes, and has several scars on his face and arms. Police urge anyone with information to please come forward. A woman has been arrested for the attempted murder of local farm magnates, the Borins, with the intention of stealing their fortune. Brianna Rose, 43.
Weren't you moving?
Let's get to the back of the property.
Oh. close as it gets. Drink up now.
Creepy.
They couldn't have gone much further.
I haven't seen any survivors yet.
That's it. Tastes good, don't it? Damn kids. Where'd they go?
No one in there. We're not leatherface.
All right.
There's nobody in there.
I can't think straight with all this craziness going on.
I'm searching for myself here. Maybe you can see a victim. That was a lovely dance. Let's try that again. Don't even know where the cat went. These other two gonna ever ready up? Why am I going against level 10s? Oh. Nope. Changed mind.
New details have emerged in the grisly string of murders that littered Interstate 40 during 1971 and 72. Known only as the Terror of I-40, authorities say an unidentified woman spent years hitchhiking from Texas to California, where she viciously murdered several truck drivers and three other young women along the route. Billy Jasper of Winslow, Arizona, claims he likely had an encounter with the assailant at his home over a year ago. Jasper says a young woman in her 20s approached his home seeking water.
That's how you do it. try this again, shall we? Squeeze one more match in. Where does Grandpa have sonar? Is he a bat? Let's see if we can do this without overheating the computer this time. Just load already. See if we can step top with all the valves and stuff. Not cook the computer this time. Let's see if that works. Come on, survivors. Or victims. Come on. People. All seven.
Celebration turned into a scene one witness described as hell on earth. Teenagers at Dutton High School were celebrating an otherwise uneventful senior dance when two local men, identified as 43-year-old Hackett Wayford and his 24-year-old son Grant Wayford, entered the gymnasium with a variety of bladed weapons and began attacking those inside. Six students, all members of the football team, managed to subdue the men before anyone was severely injured. Matthew Hickory, one of the boys responsible for ending the nightmare, told reporters that the two men were freak strong, like bulls or something. Authorities arrived and were able to arrest the men, who are now in custody. Another disturbance was reported at the abandoned slaughterhouse outside of Hills Prairie. Deputies responded to a caller reporting loud noises from the dilapidated facility after midnight. Police investigated the site and found evidence of trespassing and minor equipment theft, but suspects knew the work of local vandals. Personal belongings linked to a missing Tulsa, Oklahoma couple were found last week. Police say Tim and Tyra Devine.
Thank you.
Well, we'll do that again. Let's call it a day now before the computer kills itself again. And then we'll work out how to play this another time. See you again.